I've got a new album released, and the album's called Yond. And the album is, I wanted to get back involved with vinyl, 180 gram vinyl to me. I'm a vinyl freak anyway, I just love vinyl music. And I saw this opportunity, BMG approached me about signing a contract with them, and I thought, well, that'd be great. Now, what would I do? What would I do for a new album? And I thought, well, I'm a Moody Blue. Always have been a Moody Blue, always will be a Moody Blue. But I think for anyone wanted to know who John Lodge was outside of the Moody Blues, I think I should try and do an album that sort of reflected who I am, and hopefully brought everyone up to speed with John Lodge. And I was looking at what song should I do? And there's a film came out last year called Private Lives, and in that movie there's a song of mine called Say You Love Me. And that was off an album called Natural Avenue. And I hadn't heard the album for a long, long time. And I thought, oh, I'd like to go back in the studio and remix that as though it was 2020. And that's where I started building the album from. I found the original tapes, 24 tracks. I had to bake them, because once you play them, the oxide would have gone off. Went back in the studio and remixed that that song. And then I looked at the album and thought, what other song on the album should I do, which is diverse? And there's a song of mine called Summer Breeze, Summer Song. And there's a fantastic sax solo, which I wanted everyone to hear again. So I went in, and my friend Kenny Jones from the Faces, Small Faces, The Who, he played drums and all those. And so I rang him up and said, Kenny, I've remixed, I've got the drums really loud. And he was really pleased. But that's where I started the album from. And then I thought, what other songs can I put on the album? And there's a song of mine off Days of Future Past, which was our first album, can I say, 52 years ago. And on the B-side of the album, because it was a vinyl, there's a song of mine called Evening Time to Get Away. On the first album sleeves, it was not mentioned. It was really a deep cut, really. And I thought, well, I really want to revisit that. So I went back in the studio with my band and got my original Fender Precision Bass, which I've recorded all the Moody Blues songs with. Went in the studio, re-recorded that. And that's how I started to build the album. And then I wrote a song called Street Cafe, which is more up-tempo in a way, and I released it in England a few years ago, but never as a song on an album. So I went back in the studio and re-recorded that, and so I built the album up from that. And there's a couple of live tracks on the album as well. I wanted the live tracks to let people know that I'm on the road with my band, which is, for me, really important. You know, I have an adage from day one of have bass will travel. And since I've been 14, 15, you know, I've been playing music of an evening. Started off at youth clubs and the rest is history, I suppose. This is just a small tour, 5 dates all around this area. We're in Chicago and Milwaukee, St. Louis, and we're going to the Lincoln Theatre as well. I was really interested because the Lincoln Theatre is a really old family theatre, and it was where a lot of the original entertainment people learned everything from, you know. I think it goes back to the days of Roy Rogers and people like that. But it was on the old Route 66. And I was watching a television show in England just recently about Route 66, the old one, and they drove past the Lincoln Theatre, and I went, oh, I'm going to be playing there. So, looking forward to seeing everyone there.